Thank you very much. So first of all, I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation. It's really a pleasure and a great honor to speak in this conference for Luc Luzy, who is a master and a friend. Okay, so today I will discuss a joint work with Michel Gros about the relative hot state spectral sequence. And to introduce it, I will discuss the absolute spectral sequence first. So let me remind you a little bit the theory. K will be a complete discrete valuation field of characteristic zero with algebraically closed residue field of characteristic P. I will denote by OK the valuation ring of K. I will fix an algebraic closure, K bar of K. Denote by OK bar the integral closure of OK in K bar. GK will be the Galois group. And OC will be the completion of OK bar. And C the fraction field. I will put set for I will set S to be the spectrum of OK, S bar the spectrum of OK bar, and I will denote by S the closed point of S, eta its generic point, and eta bar the generic point of S bar. Then for any proper and smooth scheme X, we know that there is a canonical functorial GK equivariant spectral sequence called the hot state spectral sequence. It's an E2 spectral sequence, E2ij. This is H I XC omega J XC over C twisted by minus J, which converges to H I plus J etal of XK bar QP, where we extend scalars from QP to C. Okay, so this spectral sequence in fact degenerates at E2. Degenerates at E2 and even splits. And this is a consequence of the result of Tate on the Galois cohomology. So Tate proved that Hi of GK C of J vanishes for I equals 0 and 1 and G not equal to 0. Okay, so hence the spectral sequence, in fact, leads to a decomposition, which is called the hot state decomposition, Hn of xk bar qp tensor over qpc is canonically equal to the sum of hi xc omega n minus I xc over c twisted by I minus n. So this decomposition was proved by Faltings. Conjecture by Tate, sorry. So conjecture by Tate, proved by Faltings and Tsuji independently, and extends by Scholze to reach the analytic varieties. And it was Scholze who formulated the spectral sequence, though it's implicit in the work of Faltings. So the generalization I will discuss is for morphisms, and it's slightly involved. So I will start to motivate it by a local version. Okay, so let F from X to S the smooth morphism, and G from X prime to X the projective smooth morphism. So in our work, in fact, we work with toric singularities, but for simplicity, I will discuss in this lecture just the smooth case. So first, let's assume that the base affine. Let's also assume the geometric fiber, the geometric generic fiber connected, and let's choose a geometric point of x eta bar, and I will also assume that the special fiber is not empty. Okay. I will denote by the I, so first the fundamental group. So let me denote by delta the geometric fundamental group in gamma by 1 bar, and let me denote by VI the universal cover of x eta bar at y bar. Okay, so I have my diagram like this, x eta bar, it's contained in x bar, which is just the base change from x from of x from s to s bar. I have here a finite etal morphism, vi, and I can take its normalization. So all these schemes are affine, so this scheme will be also affine. And this is just the normalization of x bar in vi.
What do you mean by vi, I, and I being the universal cover?
So this is, it pro-represents the fiber functor, but you can normalize it in such a way that it's essentially unique, okay?
Ah, okay, it's a pore system, exactly. Rather than the interesting.
Yes. Okay, now I can introduce the algebra R bar, which is just the inductive limit of the algebras Ri. And on this algebra, the fundamental group acts naturally. And in this context, the natural generalization of the spectral, the Hochstedt spectral sequence is the following. So I put it as a question. So does there exist a canonical gamma equivariant spectral sequence E2ij? So it starts from Hi x prime omega j x prime of x tensor from R to R bar, where I complete periodically. I inverse all of this. This is not Japanese shock. Inverse P, twist by minus J, and this is convergence to Hi plus J etal of X prime. I take the fiber over the geometric point Y bar, QP, and I tensor over QP with R bar. Tensor over ZP with R bar hat. Okay, so this is the question. Does there exist a spectral sequence like this? So what we know by a result of Brinon and Hyodo, based on the almost purity result of Faltings, is that H naught of gamma with coefficients in R bar hat, where we inverse P, twisted by J, vanishes for all j different from zero. So if this spectral sequence exists, it will degenerate at E2. But for H1, we know that H1 of gamma with the same coefficients will vanish for j not equal to 0 and or 1 in general. It may not vanish at 1. So it's not reasonable to expect that the spectral sequence splits. So there should be no natural Hochstedt decomposition.
So are you in the case of nice reduction or only?
So I ask the question like this. After that, yeah, definitely I will take small scheme, but this is just a question in some sense. So we don't know, we cannot answer this question, but I learned from, so we will see that we can answer it after localization at a geometric point at the special fiber. But before, let me mention that Scholz told me that he's able to answer this question, definitely in the some sense in the perfectoid case, using Hochstedt filtration he defined with Cariani for proper smooth morphisms of adic spaces, which I will comment slightly later. And that Bhargav Bhatt told me that he has a strategy to construct this spectral sequence using the formalism of prismatic cohomology. So now let me tell you what we can say about this spectral sequence.
So in the result of Riodo and Brignon, is it R is nice?
Yes, R is nice, exactly. So let me just skip this. Definitely where we are able to compute the Galois cohomology. Okay, so what is our situation? So now I drop the condition that X is affine and nice. So drop the condition that X is affine. And instead I will consider X bar a geometric point of X. I will denote by X underlined the strict localization of X at X bar. I will denote by X prime underline the base change. Okay. And I will give myself a specialization from the geometric point of the generic fiber, geometric generic fiber, to the point X bar. By this, I mean just an X morphism from Y bar to the strict localization of X at X. And then I can define an algebra, which is R bar underline like this. So this will be the inductive limit over all affine etal neighborhood of X bar in X of the algebra R bar U. And this algebra is exactly the algebra I defined previously, but for the scheme U. Okay. And this choice of specialization gives me a geometric generic point of the geometric generic fiber of U. On this algebra, I have a natural action of pi 1 x underline eta y bar. And the statement is the following.
U runs through what?
U is an affine etal neighborhoods of x bar.
So this is now X is the scheme over K, yeah?
Yes, X is a scheme over OK over S. X is over S. Everything is integral, okay?
Okay, X is over S and the point is in the special fiber?
In the special fiber, yes. Okay, so sorry. Over S. Thank you. Okay. So let me now state the first result. So there exists a canonical gamma underline equivariant spectral sequence E2ij equal hi x prime underline x omega j x underline tensor over OX underline R bar hat 1 over P twisted by minus J, which converges to HI plus J etal X prime QP tensor over ZP R bar underline. And you don't need to invert P here. Okay, so this is in fact the first manifestation of this relative hot state spectral sequence. In fact, this statement could be globalized over a natural topos whose points are collections of specialization points from one from geometric point of x eta bar to a geometric point of x. This topos is nothing but just Faltings topos, which is at the heart of the hot state spectral sequence, even in the absolute case. So this is what I will explain. But before I explain it, let me mention that this spectral sequence appeared already many years ago in the work of Hyudu, who discovered in the case of a relative abelian scheme and where the localization is at the geometric generic point of the special fiber.
Here R is nice, or?
No, here there is no need for it to be nice. It's a localization. So everything is over, when it's underlined, it means it's after geometric localization at this geometric point x bar. So you can take neighborhoods which are nice. Okay. Okay, now let me introduce this topos. Faltings topos. So the situation is the following. X now is a smooth S scheme. And then I will consider E. This is, will be the category of morphisms V to U over X eta bar to X, by which I mean just commutative diagram like this of schemes, such that U to X is etal, and V to the base change, U eta bar, is finite etal. Okay? So there is a nice way to see this category is by looking at it as a fibered category over the etal site of X by mapping V U to U, okay? So if we take an object in, take an etal scheme over X, call it U, then the fiber category over U is nothing but just the finite etal site of U eta bar. And you will equip it with the etal topology. So this is why I speak about site, equipped with the etal topology. So I equip the fibers with the etal topology, and I will denote the associated topos with FET. So this is the associated topos. Okay. Now we can put a natural topology on E called the co-vanishing topology. Which was introduced first by Deligne. And it's defined in the following. So this is the topology generated by coverings VI UI to VU of the following types of the following. So we have two types. First, the vertical type, by which I mean that ui equal u for all I in I, and vi to v is a covering. And we have also the Cartesian coverings, by which I mean that ui to u is a covering, and vi is just the base change. Maybe I in R. Okay, so this is a reasonable topology on E, and we will work in the topos of sheaves of sets on E for this topology that I will denote by E tilde. So I denote by E tilde the associated topos. In fact, it's not complicated to describe objects of E tilde. So to give a sheaf, an E tilde amounts to just give a collection of sheaves for every etal scheme over X. You should give yourself a sheaf I will denote by FU, which is a finite etal sheaf over U eta bar. And this collection of sheaves should satisfy a co-cycle condition and a gluing condition. Okay. So it's a sheaf of sheaves in some sense.
The transition map satisfies.
Yes, exactly. So this is the co-cycle.
Patching. Okay.
Exactly. So moreover, we can check that any specialization map from y bar to x bar, where y bar is a geometric point of x eta bar, and x bar is a geometric point of x, defines a geometric point I will denote by rho of y bar x bar of E tilde. And the collection of these points is in fact conservative. Okay, so we are in a nice situation. Moreover, this topos is related to the usual etal and finite etal topos in the following way. So I will put it here because I need it later. First, there are two morphisms from this Faltings topos to the etal topos of X, call it sigma, and to the finite etal topos of X eta bar, call it beta. So these two maps play a role of projection. So this is defined the following way. For objects of the site, the effect of the pullback is just take this Cartesian object in some sense. And here, if you have a finite etal scheme over x eta bar, you associate to it v to x, which is well defined in E, take the associated sheaf. Moreover, there is an important morphism from the etal topos of x eta bar to the Faltings topos, which is the co-nearby cycle morphism. And it's defined the following way on objects of the sides. So if you take v to u, you just map it to v. Okay. And the first indication that this topos is relevant for the study of the etal topology of x eta bar is the following proposition, which says that the functor psi is in fact locally acyclic for local systems, which is due to Faltings in the smooth case, and it has been extended by Ashinger in the log smooth case. So it says that for any locally constant constructible torsion abelian sheaf, f on of x eta bar etal, the ri psi lower star of f vanishes for all I bigger than 1. Okay, so we will compute the periodic etal cohomology of x eta bar by computing the periodic cohomology of this topos. And for this, we will use Artin-Schreier theory. So we need a ring, and this ring is defined the following way. So when I have an object of E, I will denote by U bar V the integral closure of U bar, by which I mean always base change from S to bar, S bar, in V. And then I can define a pre-sheaf called B bar by setting that its values on VU is just the global sections of this, of the structural sheaf on this scheme. And it's a fact that B bar is a sheaf for the co-vanishing topology. So like any sheaf, as I said before, it can be written as a collection of sheaves. And in fact, these sheaves are, we have already seen them before. So like any sheaf, I can write it as a collection of sheaves for any etale scheme over X. I associate to it a sheaf I will denote it by B bar U, which is now a finite sheaf, finite etale sheaf on U eta bar. And in fact, if U is affine, and if I take Y bar, a geometric point of U eta bar, then this, the stalk of this at Y bar is nothing but just the algebra R bar U I defined previously as a representation of the geometric fundamental group, this one, okay? So it's really this representation. And hence, from this, we easily deduce that the stalk of this sheaf at the specialization, at this point associated to the specialization, is nothing but just the inductive limit of this algebra is R bar U over all affine etale neighborhoods of X bar in X. So I guess from this, you can already guess how I will globalize the spectral sequence over the ring topos E tilde B bar. So the spectral sequence I described previously will be the stalk of a spectral sequence over this ring topos. But since I need periodic topology, which previously it appears through the periodic completions, I have still just to introduce an extra notation. I have to work with projective systems. So let me give myself G a morphism from X prime to X. I will say later what are the conditions, but here just a notation. I will denote by B bar N, B bar modulo P to the N, B bar. And I will denote by B bar Brevi. So this is, will be the OC algebra of projective, so the projective system of rings B bar N, and I see this as a ring, as an OC algebra of the topos, which is made of projective systems of objects of E. So this is just the projective systems of objects of E tilde indexed by N, the ordered set N, and in fact it's a topos. Okay, I define the same way, ZP Brevi. So this is, will be the projective system of ZP, Z mod PN. And I see this in the etale topos of X prime eta bar. Okay. And the last notation I need, maybe I can describe it here. So I have X prime eta bar, which goes to X eta bar etal. So this is the morphism G I gave myself, so G eta bar. And then from here, I can go to Faltings topos, E tilde by psi. And I can extend all this to these projective systems, topos of projective systems. And I will put a Brevi to denote these maps. Okay, so now I am ready to state the main theorem. So the main theorem will take place in the category of B bar Brevi modules up to isogeny. So let me just give a name for this category. Module. So this is, will be the category of B bar Brevi modules up to isogeny. By which I mean the category with objects just B bar modules, B bar Brevi modules, and morphisms I tensor with Q. Okay? So this is in fact an analog of the category of R bar hat 1 over P representations of delta. Okay, so here now the statement. So for any, so let G from x prime to x be a smooth projective morphism,
x over the discrete valuation ring, is it?
It's a smooth. It's always smooth from here, okay?
X prime over x is smooth.
X prime over x is a smooth and projective, and x is a smooth. In fact, you in our paper, x is log smooth, but here it's just smooth.
No, but I wondered about the general question.
Yes.
You did not, when you formulate the general question about the spectral sequence.
Yeah, the affine case, you need x to be etal over gm in this context, or if it has a nice chart like Faltings. The question which I did not answer, but I would like to concentrate on this, please. Okay, so we can discuss the other question after. So I assume that G is a smooth projective morphism. Then we have a canonical spectral sequence of B bar Brevi Q modules. It starts like this. It's an E2 spectral sequence. So first of all, I take the Hodge cohomology. Okay. And then I pull it back over the Faltings topos. So I have it here. So it's something over X. Take the cohomology, then I pull it back to Faltings topos. I extend scalars over the pullback of OX to the ring B bar Brevi Q twisted by minus G. And this is converges for what? It's converges to Ri plus G, G eta bar Brevi of ZP. Brevi, so this is the relative periodic Ital cohomology, where, so it's here in some sense, and I push it to Faltings topos by the Kuhn nearby cycles, and I extend scalars to B bar Brevi Q. Okay, so this is the relative Hodge state spectral sequence. In fact, these objects, the sheaves that appear here, are naturally equipped with GK equivalent structures. And we can see that it's not difficult to see that it's GK equivalent. And from this, we deduce easily that, in fact, it degenerates at E2.
So the tensor product is over what?
ZP here.
No, in the.
Here it's the pullback by sigma of OX. So this is an OX module, and you just pull back by OX.
And sigma is the.
The first projection.
Okay.
So it's like you did here. In fact, if you take the stalk of this spectral sequence over a specialization map, you will get the spectral sequence I described, I stated before. Okay? Which means the result over the specialization, over the localization. So this is the first remark. The second remark is that we assumed here that it's projective, and I will show slightly later where we use it. It should be possible to replace it by proper. And the last remark is that, in fact, it's here by a different method. Scholz and Cariani have constructed a Hodge state filtration for the periodic cohomology, after extending to some period ring, for a proper smooth morphism of adic spaces, And this is in some sense the two analog results. And this is the result I mentioned previously. Okay, so in the remaining time, I will sketch the proof.
So using the vanishing result before, you say that the differentials are zero.
So this is slightly, it's the same spirit, but here it's just GK. Okay? I don't use the previous thing. Here I have just to compute the Galois cohomology, the GK cohomology. I don't need the gamma bar. So this is even easier than previously. Okay, so now to sketch the proof, I will start by recalling the big lines of the construction of the absolute Hoch state spectral sequence. And then I will explain how we can generalize them. So let's first assume that X be a proper smooth S scheme. Okay, so first, the first result of Faltings and extended by Ashinger, we know that Hi of X eta bar et al, Z mod P and Z is in fact isomorphic to Hi of P tilde psi lower star of Z mod P and Z. Okay, Okay, then the second point is that it's not difficult to see that the natural map from Z mod P and Z to psi lower star Z mod P and Z is in fact an isomorphism. Hence, enters now Faltings' main comparison theorem. So Faltings' main comparison theorem will tell us that the natural map from X eta bar et al, Z mod P and Z, where I extend scalars over ZP to OC, go to HI E tilde, B bar N, which means B bar modulo P to the N, this map is in fact now an almost isomorphism.
Okay, so this is what Scholz has extended the
exactly.
Primitive comparison.
Exactly. So this is was first proved by Faltings in the context of scheme, and Scholz extended in his context to his what he called primitive comparison morphism. So which means that the kernel and the co-kernel are almost isomorphisms, are almost zero. Okay, so from this, in fact, this is the target of our Hoch state spectral sequence, and it's almost isomorphic to this. So we need to compute this cohomology group. And we will compute it using a Carton-Leray spectral sequence for sigma, which is the projection from E tilde to X eta. Namely, we have a spectral sequence, an E2 spectral sequence, which is Hi X eta Lj sigma lower star of B bar N converges to Hi plus J. Of E tilde B bar N. Okay, so to go further, we need to express this term in terms of differentials. And this is we can easily do by globalizing the local computation of Faltings of Galois cohomology. So we prove in this context that there exists a canonical homomorphism of Ox bar n, which means extension of scalars to S bar modulo P to the n, algebras of the etal topos of the special fiber. So this is the algebra of differential forms, but twisted by a la Fontaine. So this is Fontaine twist, which is up to a small power of p, just state twist. So this is up to p to the 1 over p minus 1 is just state twist. So we have a natural, we have a canonical homomorphism of algebras into the direct sum of v bar n. So into this cohomology algebra. And the kernel and the co-kernel, whose kernel and co-kernel. So here they will not be killed by just the maximal ideal of OC, but killed by a precise power of P. So it's 2D plus 1 divided by P minus 1 times the maximal ideal of C. And here D is the dimension of X over S. So anyway, if we go to the projective limit and we invert P, so all this will disappear, and we find our statement, which means that this Carton-Leray spectral sequence will become the Hochstede spectral sequence. So these three steps, in fact, extend in the relative situation. Falting's main comparison theorem has been stated for morphisms by Falting in his Asterisk paper in 2002, and he sketched a proof in the appendix. And in fact, we gave a complete proof following his what he suggested. So this is the first step. The last step is easy. We will see it later, but it's easy. In fact, the main difficulty is the second step, namely the Carton-Leray spectral sequence. And the fact that it's difficult is that because there is a missing object in the picture, which is, in some sense, the main novelty of our work. So let me explain it. Okay. So let me now consider x prime to x. So this is a smooth morphism of smooth S schemes. So we can associate to x prime also a Falting's topos, and I will denote it with a prime. And the construction is functorial. So Falting's topos of x prime is naturally equipped with the morphism to Falting's topos of over x. I will denote it by theta. And moreover, the projections are also functorial. So I have here a projection to x prime et al. I have here a projection to x et al, sigma. This is g. And also the Kuhnier bicycle morphism is functorial. Okay. So I have commutative diagrams like this. And also the algebra I introduced is in some sense functorial. So I have a natural homomorphism from B bar to theta lower star of B bar prime, which is the analog algebra over E prime. So in this context, here is the generalization of Falting's main comparison theorem. So it says the following. So as I said, it's formulated by Falting, and we prove it following his sketch. So it says the following. Assume x prime to x is projective and smooth. And let f prime be a locally constant constructible sheaf of z mod p and z modules of x prime eta bar eta. Then, for any integer I, if I take the cohomology I, g eta bar, lower star, of f prime, then I push it by the Kuhnier bicycle functor to Falting's topos, and I extend scalars over zp to b bar, and I go to here, I first push by the Kuhnier bicycle functor f prime extend scalars over ZP to the ring B bar prime, and then take the direct image, higher direct image by theta. So this morphism is in fact an almost isomorphism. Okay, so observe here that this sheaf is in fact locally constructible by the proper and smooth base change. So we are in the range of where psi is locally acyclic. The other remark concerns this condition of projectivity, and this is the origin that it appears. So here, in fact, we use it to prove some almost finiteness result for almost coherent modules. And we use for this SGA6 instead of Kihl, so it should be possible to replace projective by proper, but we have not done it.
We use SGA6?
Yes.
Finiteness?
Exactly. And as I said, it should be possible, but it's already too technical. Okay, so let me go ahead. So, as we know previously, from what I said previously, Z, the direct image by psi prime of Z mod P and Z is isomorphic to Z mod P and Z. So this is, means that here, what appears here is that is the abutment of the spectral sequence we would like to construct. So it means that we are reduced to computing this side, which is in this case just the cohomology of B prime N. So we need to compute this cohomology by spectral sequence. Okay? So let's look a little bit to the situation. So we have E prime. It maps to X prime etal. Here we have X etal. Here we have Faltings topos. And here our theta. So to compute it by Cartan-Leray spectral sequence, clearly we need a factorization of this theta. And the first thing which comes to mind is to take just the fiber product of this topos, which exists. So I will call this map tau, and this is gamma. And to write the Cartan-Leray spectral sequence for this composition. In fact, it turns out that this topos has a very nice underlying site, which is a generalization of Faltings site, which we were able to define by inspiration from oriented products of De Ligne, beyond the co-vanishing topos, which serves already to the definition of Faltings topos. So this is in fact the missing object that I will now describe. And then I will explain how to perform the three steps. So let me denote by now G the category of pairs of morphisms W to U, V to U. And this is over, we have X prime to X. And here we have X eta bar to X. So I take commutative diagrams like this, such that this is etal. This is etal, and here I ask that V to U eta bar is finite etal, as before. And I will equip it with the topology, which is the following. So I take plus the topology generated by coverings. So UI, VI. WUV of three types now. So, of three types. So, the first type is just WI equal W and UI equal U for all I, but VI to V is a covering. The second type is UI equal U, VI equal V for every I in I, but WI to W is a covering. And the most important type is the third one. So this is the type C, where the I is just one element, so I can denote it with a prime instead of I. So I have an object like this over UV. And in fact, what I ask is that these two are equal, and I have here a morphism. And this diagram is Cartesian. But this map could be any map. Okay? So this is exactly, in some sense, copying the definition of the co-vanishing of the oriented product topology. So I obtained a nice site, and I will denote the associated topos with G tilde. Okay? So if X prime is equal to X, we immediately see that, in fact, this topos is canonically equivalent to Faltings topos. So from this, we see by functoriality of this construction that we have a factorization, which I will draw here. So I have E tilde prime. It goes to this Faltings topos, goes to E tilde. Moreover, the construction of the projections are factorial, as I explained. So let me put here the second projection. Fet beta prime x beta fet. This is beta. Okay, and here I have x prime etal and x etal. And I have the first projection, sigma prime and sigma. And in fact, we can extend this diagram by two morphisms, which also are kind of projections. This one I will call pi, and this is I will call lambda. And they are defined in a very natural way. So if I have a w, which is etal over x prime, I associate to it w to x, x eta bar by pi upper star. And here, if I have V, which is finite etal, I associate to it just x prime to x V associated by lambda upper star. Okay, so I call this map tau. This is gamma. So I can now, okay, and what else? And in fact, we prove, and this is a fact, that this diagram is Cartesian, which means that this topos is the fiber product. Okay, so now we can go to our problem of spectral sequences. So, using Faltings main comparison theorem, I know that psi lower direct image of Ri g eta bar of z mod p and z, where I extend scalars from Zp to B bar, is in fact almost isomorphic to the direct image of B prime n. So this is Faltings main comparison. So as I said, our target is to compute this one by spectral sequence, and we use here the Carton-Leveret spectral sequence for the composition theta is equal to gamma composed with tau. So it looks like this. Is equal to Ri gamma lower star Rj to lower star of B bar prime n converges to Ri plus j theta lower star of B prime n. So to find the Hochstedt spectral sequence, we have to express this term in terms of differentials. And this is, as I said, we can globalize Faltings computation of local. So first of all, we can extend Faltings computation of Galois cohomology to a relative situation, and then we can globalize it. So to formulate the statement, I will use pi, but I need to enrich it a little bit. So I will equip G tilde with a ring, which is nothing but just the direct image of the ring B prime by tau, and I map it to X prime etal, and I equip it with the ring O X prime, but X prime I have to push it down, X bar prime, So I have to push it down from x bar prime to x prime, and I call this map h bar prime. Okay, so I use this morphism of ring topos. So the next theorem is that for any n bigger than 1, there is a canonical homomorphism of B bar upper Schlick algebras over this Faltings topos from the exterior algebra of the pullback of the twisted sheaf of differentials x bar prime over n modulo x bar prime x bar n, and this is goes to the direct image of B prime n. Okay, so this is and this has a kernel whose kernel and co-kernel are killed by p to the 2 r plus 1 divided by p minus 1 times the maximal ideal of C, and here r is the relative dimension. Okay, so this is nice. We find the relative differentials, but we are not completely done. So what we find is we have the relative differentials here, and we pull them back here. So we have to take direct image, but we prefer to first take direct image and then pull back. And this is what we wrote. So we need base change. And this is the last part of the lecture. So very quickly, I will state just the result. So how we will prove this base change results? In fact, first we prove the base change result for torsion coefficients. This is just a generalization of a result due to offer in the oriented product case. And it's just, it reduces just to the proper base change theorem for G. Okay, so this is the first step. And after that, we need to use almost purity to prove proper base change for coherent coefficients. So let me finish by stating this result. Assume that G is proper and always smooth. Then there exists an integer n bigger than 0 such that for any n bigger than 1 and any q bigger than 0 and any coherent O x prime n module, I will call it f, which is flat over xn, which is xn flat. Okay, the kernel and co-kernel of the natural base change morphism sigma upper star of RQ G lower star of F going to RQ gamma lower star of pi upper star of F. So the kernel and co-kernel are killed by P to the N. And this pullback here are pullback for the natural morphism of ring topoi. Yeah, and that's all. So I think I should stop here.
And you have the usual coverings which are flat, and then the rest is kind of almost the tal, and so you can control.
Yes, you can control cohomology. So exactly. So once you have the base change for the coefficients, ital coefficients, you can get the remaining part. For instance, one thing is that you have two rings here, B and OX prime. And if you take the exterior tensor product here, it's almost isomorphic to the ring two lower star. So you have OX prime here, You have B bar here, and I put a ring here, which is just the direct image of B prime. Okay? So this is upper Schrieck, and this is prime. So this ring is almost isomorphic to the tensor product of these two. This is already, but you take the pullback and take the tensor product over OX. Okay, and this is already, uses already almost purity.
So in your original question on the existence of the Hallstatt spectral sequence,
yes,
over an affine situation,
yes.
So which in which level of generality is it expected to work?
Okay.
There are better results, like, I mean, there is, so before, like in the time of Altings, it was possible to calculate things with certain toric singularities,
yes.
But using the perfectory theory and other things now with prismatics, I mean, you don't need all of it, but still, so what is the current?
So in some sense, if you remain the spirit of what I said today, to be safe, what I expect is that if you work with the small scheme, in the sense, for example, in the smooth case, in the sense that it's etal over GMS,
yes,
or in the log situation, which means that you have a chart, a nice chart, as you know. So in that case, I expect that spectral sequence exists. But in the context, more general context of Scholze, you are right. We should expect this in the case where we have a perfectoid. So
it is true in general, and not difficult to prove. I don't know if it was the reference, but Faltings even remarked it during the periodic semester that when you normalize in the maximal etal extension of the general fiber, you get something perfected, where it's not called perfected,
yes,
this time, but you can just write down.
Sure, but this is in the context of smallness.
No, without smallness. Faltings remarked that using certain,
really?
Equations, yeah, this was I don't know where it is in the literature, but what you do is, suppose you want to take the piece root of something, then you write the equation x to the piece,
yeah,
square minus.
Yeah, this is to prove, I see what you mean. Sure.
To get piece roots of functions on the special fiber.
Yes.
Let us say at least when things are.
Yeah, I know this.
Around, yes, the special fiber. So in modern language, it means that you get a perfectoid.
Yes.
Now, of course, you don't control, but in any case, the fact that, so Faltings calculated what is now called this O plus.
So I think we are getting a new proof of the statement I was saying by Gabber now. So I don't know what you want to formulate in some sense. You want to extend the what is the best expected situation for the local statement I gave?
In any case, Scholz proved in the general rigid analytic case, so Scholz gave a proof of local constancy of the entire local system, so at least, but I don't know if he, okay, for this you need this more refined, at least the way you do it, you need the local calculation, so you are limited to the Faltings. Okay, I don't know.
Okay, thanks.
Fully disappeared or what?
No. He's here.
Yeah. Other questions?
Luke has a question.
Yeah, but maybe other people, I don't know.
So what is the, so you said that Delin defined the co-vanishing. What was it in the oriented product, or he did this more generally for this?
No, Faltings defined his topos in the beginning, as you know.
Yes.
And this. Yes, okay. And but this one did not appear. So this is in the new thing in our paper.
No, but when you mentioned Delin for the co-vanishing, what do you refer to?
So Delin, in fact, suggested from the beginning when Luc wrote Bourbaki on periodic Hallstatt decomposition, he suggested to Luc that the oriented product should appear, and it remained a little bit unused till we started to work with Michel.
No, but this thing was the horizontal and vertical topology,
yes,
that you call the co-vanishing topology.
Yes.
Was it in Delin?
No, like this, it's a generalization of him, but it's not far, so it's in my work with Michel.
Okay.
It was in his letter to me, essentially.
I don't know if he used really the finite et al. I think he
not, really.
Not, yeah, exactly. So this is just the Yeah, so Luke, you can ask him.
So, I don't know, maybe we don't have much time, but I think this intermediate thing, this factorization, reminds me of a relation between generalized psi, when you have a morphism. So then you get some oriented map, which compares the two. And so it, in the situations of an analog for the co-vanishing tall person somehow. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's the first remark. And the second is that I would like, perhaps in a few words, perhaps it's too complicated, to explain how the in a theorem above, on the middle board, mm-hmm. the map from pi per star of xi minus 1 omega 1 to R1, tall R, lower mm-hmm. star, how is it defined? So some kind of comparison of Galois cohomology with differential.
Yeah.
And, so how does it come?
So as you said, it's complicated to explain in very few words, but roughly speaking, as you can expect, there is an extension which lead this one. This morphism will be the boundary of a long exact cohomology sequence of that extension, and that extension is in fact Faltings extension. So this is when you have a Faltings extension, but you have to globalize it in certain sense. So when Faltings extension exists, you can define it like this. And you can, in general, so our trick to define this without using Faltings extension is to use Kummer theory over over this Faltings topos and to construct a map and to prove that locally it coincides with the other one. Then we see that its kernel and co-kernel are nice.
And the xi minus 1 is like omega 1 of OK bar, something like that.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
What was the first
one? Okay, so. Yeah. Okay. Yes, okay. Okay, so if there is no further questions, so we'll have a break and we'll resume in 8 minutes. Okay, at 10:15.
Thank you.